We're going to move on now to our GMA cover story. Dance Mom star Abby Lee Miller out of prison now, about to make her return to TV. And she spoke with Paula Ferris about surviving a difficult health battle behind bars. Hey, Paula.
Hey there, George. Good morning, everyone. So Abby Lee survived prison. She beat cancer. She's been through a lot. But when I asked her specifically how prison had changed her, she says, "You don't want to know." But then she detailed how she was threatened and mistreated during her time behind bars.
Too sloppy. Get up in the air on that.
This morning, the hard-charging, larger-than-life Dance Mom star, Abby Lee Miller.
And everybody's watching you cry. Save your tears for the pillow.
Getting candid about her 8 months in prison for bankruptcy fraud.
How does an experience like that change you personally?
It's a joke. Wouldn't I have done better teaching underprivileged children to dance or, just working, find me, whatever. It's absolutely asinine. The entire thing.
Are you treated any different because you are a quote-unquote celebrity?
I was, by the guards, by the prison system, absolutely.
Did you ever feel threatened in prison?
Only by the staff, by the guards. I was, where's that dance lady? Where's that TV star lady? We're gonna get her.
They said that they were going to get you.
Yeah, they come into your room, they take your locker, they dump everything out of it, they take red soda pop and shake it up and spray it all over your clothes. When a man or somebody, a woman in power, screams the F word at you over and over and over again, to me that's offensive. That's violent to me. And that went on a lot. Trying to pull my eyelashes off that were extensions.
They were pulling your eyelashes off?
The first day I went in. And she kicked my bed and she screamed at me.
The Federal Bureau of Prisons would not comment specifically on Miller's allegations, citing inmate privacy, but in a statement to ABC News said that it provides, quote, a safe, secure, and humane environment for staff and inmates, adding that if there are allegations of misconduct, they are taken seriously and, when appropriate, referred for proper investigation. Miller, meantime, reflecting on her time behind bars by offering advice for actresses Lori Loughlin and Felicity Huffman, who are both facing possible prison time for their alleged involvement in a college admission scandal, Varsity Blues. Loughlin has pleaded not guilty in the case.
What should they expect if they have to do prison time?
The girls in prison are going to be fans. They want to know what it's like to live with a movie star or, a television star. They want to know about your case. Everybody in there, every single woman that I came in contact with, just wants to tell their story. I don't know those two ladies personally, but from their television personas, I don't think they would have the same issues that I had.
Okay.
Because, everybody knows me as being tough and mean and yelling at little kids.
After leaving prison in March 2018, Miller was ready to start a new life. But then another setback. She was diagnosed with Burkitt lymphoma, discovered after an emergency back surgery.
What would have happened had they said, go home?
I would have been dead 10 minutes.
10 minutes?
10 minutes.
You were that close to dying.
That close to dying. I was paralyzed from the neck down. No movement. Because this cancer, this lymphoma, was choking my spinal cord.
Miller endured 10 rounds of chemo and 2 surgeries. She still can't walk.
Do the doctors anticipate that she'll be able to walk again?
Yes. Right now, the biggest issue is my right knee. I have needed a knee replacement for about 7 years now.
When do you want to walk again?
Right now, today.
What does that say about you that you beat this strong cancer?
Well, I'm tough. And I firmly believe that all the world's a stage and we are merely the players. So I think this was all destiny. It was supposed to happen this way and it did. And I'm just following the script.
One word to describe how different you are.
More appreciative. Thankful.
Now 52, Miller is getting back to what she does best.
I've been given a second chance. Will this team have what it takes to carry on my legacy?
Returning to the spotlight for season 8 of Dance Moms, the show that made her famous.
At the end of the day, I'm a teacher. It's what I do. Just needs to be bigger, bigger, bigger than life or the internet.
What are these kids in for?
They're in for the ride of their lives.
You're notoriously tough on these kids. Do you ever regret maybe going too far?
Never.
Never?
Never.
You survived prison.
Yes.
You beat cancer.
Yes.
How does that change who you are, Abby?
It doesn't change me. I've always been a fighter. for every mistake I've made, I've had to just come back tougher, come back stronger, come back better.
So I asked her, who's tougher, the prison guards or these unreasonable dance moms that she has to deal with? And she said, without hesitation, the prison guards were tougher.
Oh, I thought you were going to say the other.
No, well, it's kind of a toss-up, yeah. Really. But season 8 premieres on Lifetime early June. She says she's also looking forward to creating some shows. She's in the process of that right now. Hopefully she gets to pitch those in the near future.
Okay. Thank you, Cheryl.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.